Hi.
Oh, hi, honey. Yeah. Oh, you're here to go on a diet, yeah?
Yes, please.
Perfect. Well, I've got a few for you to choose from.
Okay. I was hoping to learn about calories and how to be in a deficit.
Don't be silly, honey. You don't need to learn about that. So, have you tried eating a grapefruit before each meal?
No.
That's where you're going wrong. You really should. So, Reese Witherspoon did this before each meal. 800 calories a day she was eating. Full. How about a juice cleanse?
I was hoping to actually eat some food.
Okay, getting a bit picky now. Baby food. Baby food diet. Oh, I swear by it. Jennifer Aniston did it. Cheryl Cole too.
I think
don't want to look like them. Fine. The word diet is thrown around quite a lot. You hear people wanting to diet for weddings, holidays, birthdays, absolutely any occasion. But far too often you hear people saying that their diet failed, or it did work and then it failed because they put all the weight back on. And there are a few reasons for this. There are a few reasons that people are going into diet and they are not working successfully. So I thought I'd talk about it today. I'll talk about the five main reasons that diets fail, but then also explain how you can have a successful diet. And I'm gonna put that around the word diet. How you can have a successful diet and lose the weight that you want to. The word diet literally means to restrict oneself to a small amount of food in order to lose weight. So really, a diet can't not work. So let's talk about these five reasons and discuss why they're not working. The first one, and I think this is very common for people because they hear diet, you have to eat less food, so it becomes too restrictive. They'll basically work out how many calories they should be eating and then go way too low. The issue with this is, yes, it does mean you lose weight. The rule, calories in, calories out. So you are taking in less calories, so you are gonna lose weight. However, you're restricting yourself so much that you will eventually binge or you'll eventually give up. You cannot sustain that. You can't live your life on such little amount of calories. It's also a super depressing lifestyle. You'll be super annoyed at people. You'll be really tired, and that's not really the life you wanna live. So restricting your calories too much may be the reason that your diet isn't working. A diet needs to be a lifestyle. You need to be able to keep it up long term. It needs to be your everyday life. So that means not restricting yourself too much. There are plenty of diets out there that tell you that you cannot have carbs, that you cannot have sugar. And if you restrict yourself that much, you're gonna struggle. You're gonna be thinking constantly, oh my God, I just want some pasta. And if you restrict yourself that much, you're gonna end up binging. The second reason that most diets fail is it's not actually enjoyable. I think the word diet has a very negative stigma attached to it. People see diet as a negative thing. They see it as broccoli and chicken every night. They see it as not really being able to play around with different foods, being able to cook nice things, but that's not true. You don't have to have the most basic meal plan. To lose weight, you have to be in a calorie deficit, and that means having less calories than your maintenance calories, or just burning more calories. But we're talking about diets here, so let's talk about having a calorie deficit. So you just need to ensure that you're having foods, and all of those foods are less than your calorie maintenance. So that means you can have those chicken wings that you want. You can have the occasional chocolate bar, but it just means you can't have too many of those things so that you go over it and you are in a calorie surplus. And if you want a video on how to work out your calorie maintenance, how to work out how many calories you should be having in a day, make sure to drop a comment below because I'll definitely do that. Number three, and I genuinely believe this is one of the main reasons that diets don't work. And this is, you've already told everyone you're dieting. How many people have told you before, or maybe you've done it, that they are on a diet? They'll be at a restaurant and they'll say, can't have that, I'm on a diet. They'll go to a bar and say, can't drink that, I'm on a diet. Cool, you are on a diet, good for you. However, a lot of people say they're on a diet before actually acting on it. Because you've already got that gratification, you've told people that you've done something, and people are proud of you, they're congratulating you. So you're sitting back thinking, yeah, I am on a diet, I'm great, while tucking into a fucking huge chocolate bar. It doesn't work like that. Once you've got that gratification, a lot of people do give up. You've already got the buzz, you've already got the excitement of achieving something, but you haven't achieved it yet. So one thing I always suggest is just keep yourself to yourself. Eat what you want. Don't have to tell everyone about it, because if you go around bragging about things, sometimes you're doing it for the wrong reasons and you don't actually end up achieving what you want to achieve. The fourth reason that most diets don't work is because you don't actually understand it. I'm not saying you need to be a scientist and you need to know all the medical jargon for it, but you do actually need to understand what it takes to lose weight. And like I've said many times in this video, it's calories in, calories out. So if you look at something like one of those liquid diets, you know, where they literally give you smoothies and blend shit up constantly, the only reason that might work for you is because you're taking in less calories than you were before you did that diet. But again, it's not enjoyable. It's not sustainable. You can't drink smoothies or liquid stuff for the rest of your life. But that's the reason that diet actually works, maybe just for a small amount of time. I'm seeing a lot of people jumping on diet trends, especially ones they see from celebrities and influencers, but they don't actually understand it. Realistically, you want a diet that is a lifestyle. So you need to pick something that you understand. And for me, and I think for the rest of the world, that means eating whatever food groups you want, being able to eat yummy food, but still lose weight. And the best way to do that is to eat less calories than your maintenance, putting you in a calorie deficit. The fifth and final reason that most diets fail is because it's a business. Diet plans are often designed by large companies, influencers, businesses. They're there to make money. So they won't exactly teach you. They won't tell you how to lose the weight. They'll just ensure that you need to stick to that plan. You need to stay with them for as long as possible. Weight Watchers is a perfect example of this. So you get like points deducted for eating sugary things and stuff. If that works for you, okay. But you're spending money on something which really you could, well, you definitely could do yourself. They're not teaching you why certain food groups are bad, because they're not bad. They're just telling you they're bad. You shouldn't be told that if you eat a food, that's wrong for you. You should just be explained why maybe that has more calories in than something else. Weight Watchers is actually huge. Like, they make so much money. They sold to Heinz in 1978, and then they were bought by an investment firm in 1999 for £735 million. That's how much money there is in this diet culture. That's how much money there is in people that are desperate to lose weight. So you're probably thinking, how can I lose weight, Maddie? You've just told me loads of reasons why I'm probably failing at it. Well, like I've said many times, calories in, calories out. So you need to ensure you're eating less calories than your maintenance. And you can choose a calorie calculator online to find out what this is. But you still want to enjoy food. So the easiest way to do this is to understand the foods that you love. Understand how many calories there are in it. Because you might be eating something like peanut butter by the jar and not realize that there's a lot of calories in that. Peanut butter is the best. But there are also alternatives to peanut butter like PB Fit, which I also love. You can find lower calorie alternatives. Or you can just have them occasionally, who cares? So overall, diets are bullshit. Don't go on a diet. Just look at what you're eating. Work out the calories. Work out how much you're eating. Work out if you can sustain this, if you can eat the way you're eating for the rest of your life, and you're good to go. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, give it a like. If you have any questions or you have any other content you want me to cover, put a comment below, and I'll see you in the next one.